Hi friends, welcome to Varalakshmi's physics classes. In this video we are going to know about the types of motion. See, the first type is rectilinear motion. When a body moves along the straight line, the motion described by the body is called as a rectilinear motion. So we can say that this type of motion is about a one-dimensional motion. See, when the body here the moving along a straight line, either horizontal or vertical direction, but the body is moving along a straight line motion, so such type of motion is called as a rectilinear motion. So example is the freely falling stone. If you hold the stone at certain height, if you leave it, then it will go straight to the ground. So a freely falling stone is a example for the rectilinear motion. Another example is a coin moving over a carom board. For carom board also we use a straight line motion. Now let us see about the another motion, that is circular motion. A motion of an object is along the circumference of a circle. See, this is not going inside, it is along the circumference of a circle. If you see, this is the circle and the body moves along the circumference of a circle. This is the center of the circle. Body will move along the circumference of a circle. Such type of motion is called as a circular motion. And here the example is the satellites orbiting the earth. Satellites revolving around the sun in particular paths, those are circular paths. So satellites orbiting the earth is the best example for the circular motion. Another type is the rotatory motion. A motion in which body moves about a fixed axis. Here body is moving about a fixed axis without changing its position. So but in the case of a circular motion, body as a whole body is moving along the circumference of a circle, but in case of a rotatory motion, body is moving about a fixed axis. That axis is called as a axis of rotation and without changing its position. So such type of motion is called as a rotatory motion. Example is the water wheel and also spinning top and ceiling fan. See, I'll explain in detail the difference between these two. If you consider a fan as a whole object, see a law. See here, if you consider a fan as a whole object, this is performing rotatory motion, because here the fan was in a fixed position and this is called an axis of rotation. See, this line is called axis of rotation. It was moving along a particular axis, it was rotating along a particular axis, that is called axis of rotation. But if you consider a point on a blades of the fan, see it, when we switch on this fan, this blade will undergoes circular motion. If you consider fan as a whole object, it was performing a rotatory motion, but if you consider a point on a single blade, it was performing a circular motion. So the difference between circular motion and the rotatory motion is, see here, axis of rotation will be a part of the body for rotatory motion. Axis of rotation will be the part of the body. But in case, see here, suppose if you consider this is an earth, satellites was orbiting in a circular path. See here, if you consider this as a satellite, this was performing a circular motion, but it was not coming inside. The earth will also have a certain axis of rotation. Earth is also rotating on its own axis. This was performing a rotational motion, but here the satellite was performing the circular motion. Here, if this is a clear example, fan was as a whole object, fan was performing a rotatory motion, but if you consider a point on a single blade, it when we switch on the fan, it will performs the circular motion. That is the difference between the circular motion and the rotatory motion. Let us see another motion, that is oscillatory motion. The to and fro or back and forth motion of an object is called as a oscillatory motion. See here, to and fro or back and forth, forward and backward motion described by an object as a whole. As a whole, it will moves along the same path without change in the shape or size. Its shape won't be changed, but it moves forward and backward. That is called as the oscillatory motion. Example is a boy on a swing and pendulum of a clock, needle of a swing machine are the best examples for the oscillatory motion. And the next type is vibratory motion. It is also a kind of oscillatory motion. Vibratory motion is also the kind of oscillatory motion, but in which object undergoes the change in shape. But in case of the oscillatory motion, there is no change in shape. But in this vibratory motion, object undergoes the change in shape or size. But in oscillatory motion, there is no change in the shape of an object or size of an object. The best example is a musical instrument such as guitar, violin, star, drums produces a vibratory motion. If you see that these musical instruments, they will perform the those objects which have the strings also will perform the vibratory motion. When we plug the string of those music instruments, it undergoes the change in its shape. So that is called as a vibratory motion. Let us see another type, that is called as a periodic motion. A repetitive motion which repeats itself, it is called repetitive motion. Periodic motion is nothing but it is a repetitive motion which repeats itself after a fixed interval of time is called as a periodic motion. After a fixed interval of time itself, it will be repeats. Such type of motion is called as a periodic motion. Best example is the heart of a normal resting person beats 72 times per a minute. So that is the example. And also the a needle of a swing machine running at a constant speed is also the best example for the periodic motion. I hope you like the video. Please do like, share and subscribe. Thank you for watching this video.